Hello, my name is Arnaud Delorme, and this is a series of video on automated processing pipeline in different EEG processing software. This one is about EEGLAB, and since you are on the EEGLAB channel, you can guess which pipeline is going to be better. Now let's get started with this pipeline. As with the other pipeline, we're going to use the same data file. So first I'm going to show you from the GUI, and then I'm going to show you from the command line. So here I'm going to import the data. So load the existing data set, and I'm going to plot it. So see, there's a lot of offset right here. We also see all these channels we don't need. So we're going to remove them and remove the offset by filtering. First removing the channels we don't need. Are these ones, and you don't have to remove them. You can actually process all the data by excluding them. It's just more convenient to remove them here since we're not going to process them. Then I'm going to filter the data, and I'll use the first one, high pass filter at 1 hertz here. And then before I look at it again, I'm going to remove the average reference. Compute average reference. Now this is how the data looks like. So next we are going to remove artifacts using a clean raw data and artifact subspace reconstruction. And here I don't need to filter the data. This is the part to remove channels. I have a channel correlation here at 0.8. So this is the minimum correlation for channels. If I want to remove more channels, I put this number higher. Here, this is the artifact subspace reconstruction, even though we're only using the part that detects bad data. We're not using the actual reconstruction of the data. And this part here is the last pass where it just uses threshold to remove remaining bad portions of data. We have this checkbox checked here, so we're going to look at the result. So now we can look at the result of the rejection. We see this part has been rejected. These channels were labeled as bad. This part was rejected probably because of this discontinuity. And then this part was rejected because of the high frequency. So we just press OK. And now we're going to run ICA. You can use the default. I like to use PCAR because it's faster. Next, we're going to flag bad components using ICLabel. We're going to plot some of the components. That's 1 to 10. So we see this one, this is eye at about 95%. This is lateral eye movements at about 98%. The other ones are brain components with high confidence. So we're just going to reject these two based on their likelihood of being an artifact. So we go back here, flag components as artifact. And basically, if it's above 90%, either in the muscle or eye category, we label them as artifact. So here you see two components flagged for rejection. And these were the two components I showed you. Now here, I'm going to remove the components from the data. And you don't have to do that in EEGLAB because at the study level, it can dynamically remove the components when you want to calculate some channel measures. But here, because I'm comparing the clean data between different software, I need to remove them at this point. So I'm just going to press yes. And then you can plot single trial data to see the difference before and after component rejection. Here we can try to stack them. We see here some small deflection, which represent eye movements. I'm going to accept the rejection and save as a new data set. So now I'm going to extract data epochs. So oddball and standard. And I could extract both at the same time here, selecting these two. But here I want two different data sets, so I can have the oddball trials on one side and the standard trials on the other side, which will help me to compare with other pipelines. So let's do the oddball first. Oddball. Just press OK. Minus 300 for the baseline. And here I'm going to save it as oddball. That's it. And I'm going to go back to the clean data and do the same for the standard. So now I have two data set, one with standard, one with oddball. These are the standard you see here. EEG data contains 60 channels by 768 points by 441 trials. Now I'm going to quickly plot standard versus oddball. And for this, I need to create a study. So I'm going to clear all. I'm going to re-import the standard and oddball data sets I just saved. I'm going to create a study using these two data sets for group analysis. Pressing OK. Then I need to tell EEGLAB what to compare. So here I want to compare oddball and standard. So that's a new study design. The type oddball with n standard. That's one category called variable. Then I need to pre-compute ERPs. I don't need to compute other measures here. I could remove ICA components, but I've already done it. And then I can plot the channel measures. So select all the channels, overlay them on each other. And here we can see the typical oddball. I can also plot topography, say at 350 milliseconds. And we can clearly see the oddball are different from the standard. And I can also compute statistics and correct for multiple comparison using FDR. Usually statistics are done for different subjects when you have different subjects in your study. But if you have one subject, you can use single trials to compute statistics. So I'm going to check the single trial checkbox right here. And you can see most of the channels are significant. So we've done one analysis. Now we're just going to copy and paste the script. We want to write a script, and with EEGLAB it's easy. You just type EEGH, or you go here, say history script, save session history. I like to type EEGH and copy and paste into a new script. I'm going to call it EEGLAB script. Save it. I'm going to check that it works. Now the last part is I'm going to clean up that script, remove all the storing, etc., which are not needed. I'm just processing one data set here. I don't need to plot. This is filtering. No plotting. Selecting the bad channels, cleaning the data, running ICA, labeling components, flagging components, subtracting the components. This is empty, so it means these are the ones which are flagged, which are removed. Extracting oddball, removing the baseline, saving the oddball, then extracting the standard, removing the baseline. So this is the final script. Here on top is pre-processing, epoch extraction, study creation, and epoch plotting. I could also have saved the dataset history instead of the session history, and then I would not have all the spurious commands. But then I would have one for a standard and then one for oddball. And I wouldn't have the script that fuses the two. So it's just easier to clean up the script. And again, it works even if you don't clean up the script. And that's it for this video. So I hope to see you in one of the other videos when I compare these pipelines.